Hi, this is Craig Daniels. Welcome to Craig's Classroom. In this recording, I wanted to show you how it is that you can create a block of emphasis text in your blog post. And to illustrate what that means, take for instance in this blog post here, I have a photo, a lead-off photo. And then as we go down into the article itself, you can see instead of using another photo here, I took some of the words that were an I wanted to emphasize from the post and then made them larger and offset them over to the right. So this is what I'm calling a block of emphasis text. Now, this happens to be helpful in times that perhaps you can't find a photo that maybe goes well with your story, or maybe you have a little bit longer article and you wanted to maybe didn't you already used a photo, and maybe now to use this as an example, you might want to highlight a main point, and as opposed to just leaving it all text, and that's a lot of words sometimes for people to digest. So by doing these different things graphically, you can draw interest to your main point by, as you can see, as this text highlights the particular thing that could be drawn attention to. And I took this excerpt over from Dick Greenberg. And he had a post recently, The Sun Wasn't Shining, and he came into this post with a lead-off photo. But as he's telling his story down here, you can see that there's a lot of good information here, but we could add emphasis to maybe another point as we I'll show you how that works in just a second, by maybe highlighting this emphasis text. So let's I'm gonna I already took the text here, copy clipped it over into a new draft post here, and I'm going to show you how to create this block of emphasis text if you want to use that in your own blog posts. Now, the first thing that we need to be able to do is to create a container to hold the block of text. And I'm going to click here in the body of my text where I want to insert this block of text. So where I'm going to click here to insert my point, and then we're going to create a block or a container for this text, and then we're going to tell it to go to the right hand side. So first of all, let's create the container. And in blogging, a good way to create a container is to use a table. So up on the blogging toolbar, you can click this to get the drop down choices. You can click on Insert Table, and you can see that a table consists of cells. So you can have rows. You can see a row goes across, a column goes down, and you can create so many rows and so many columns when you're creating a table. And that helps you format a block of text into so that everything aligns. Now we only are creating this particular container so that we can tell it we want that container to float on its own. So we don't actually need to create rows and columns. I just need a table that contains one cell. So I'm going to go ahead and just click on that first cell there, and that's going to insert into my document a one cell table. Now it's a little confusing at this point as to this doesn't look much like a table, but it's really created a very tiny table. And if I were to hover here on the right edge and then click and drag, I can drag that right edge over, and I'm going to take it about a third of the way across. And now you can see now that cell of that table has a width to it, and I can put something into that cell. So I'm going to come down into the text itself, and I'm going to highlight the thing that I wanted to bring emphasis to. It says, "So very reluctantly, they took the third choice." I'm going to go ahead and copy that to the clipboard, come up into my cell, and paste it. And then I need to make that text bigger. So I'm going to highlight the text again, come up to my toolbar, font sizes, click the 24-point option. It's up to you to what size you want, but I'm going to choose 24. That's a nice large size. And it's doing an interesting thing here that is kind of cutting off my text. So this text had maybe some formatting associated with it that's causing us a little bit of a problem. So there's a little tip here that you can go up to the toolbar again. The very last tool on the bottom says Clear Formatting. And that will just take away any formatting that might have been causing us some problems with this particular text. It wipes out all the formatting, and now I can try the point size again, and this time it went ahead and made it so it wasn't cutting it off. So the next thing that I need to do is I need to take this table and move it over so it's floating on the right-hand side of my text area. So you notice if I click outside of that table and then click back inside of that table, You can tell you're inside of a table because you have all these highlight, these little squares that are around the outside highlighting that that's the boundaries of the table. If I'm inside of a table, I can come back up to my toolbar here, click on this pull down, and one of the things here is table properties. Clicking in there, and I can go ahead and tell it that I want the alignment of that table to be on the right side. Now watch what happens. That whole table shifts over to the right-hand side, and that frees up this left-hand side to be my regular text, and that text is going to flow around my floating table. So you can start to see how this is already starting to look like what we wanted, the result that we wanted it to be. Now I could add some more formatting here. Perhaps I want to highlight a particular word and make it bold, so I give it a little bit of a punch. And another thing I'm going to do is I'm going to, you don't have to do this, but there's something also called a horizontal line. So if I put my cursor at the end, click on horizontal line, it'll go ahead and draw a line underneath that goes across the width of the table. And we could take a look at this in the preview mode here just to see how things are coming together. And you can see how that large text, it's floating over here, the text is wrapping around it. Now what also can happen is sometimes this white space in between, this could happen with the picture and it's happening with us now a little bit with the table, is that these words can actually start to run together. They can actually almost touch at some point. So what you want to do is add a little white space in between. So again, I'm going to click inside the table up to my table properties, and in a table you can add something called a cell padding. So if I were to type 20, that would be 20 pixels, and that would give it white space all the way around. And then I can choose to say, well, maybe I need to make it a little bit wider now because it's wrapping my words a little bit funky. So I can freeform this a little bit and just make it however I'd like. I can make it extra wide or somewhere as so. And you can see that padding now, that cell padding, is giving me some white space here so that my words are not going to be touching each other. And we don't wouldn't want that because that would look bad. And you can see, really, it's fairly easy then to create a block of emphasis text. It's really a matter of just creating a table, inserting your words, making them larger, going into table properties, tell it the alignment's going to be on the right-hand side. And then just being able to tweak it a little bit and make sure it has the look that you want. And then the last thing I always like to do is just to go into preview mode and just to see how it comes out in the final appearance so that you can see what it's going to look like. So that's what you can do then in order to. Another choice that you have besides inserting photos and pictures and graphics is you can actually use some of the words from your blog post to create an emphasis point so that you can draw the reader's eye into your article and keep their attention. Thanks for joining me today. Again, this is Craig Daniels. You can catch me on my ActiveRain blog and find more articles like this. Also, please check out my YouTube channel for more tutorials like this one. It's youtube.com/techzmx, TECHZMX. Thanks for watching today. Bye-bye.